it. Fucking right, we did it. What the fuck you gon' do? Hit me, run up on you. Fuckin' with the wrong crew. You know what we gon' do. All I have to show niggas how we do it.
Guys, what's up? It's Mark. Check this out. I got a special final salute kind of thing. This is one of my personal machines. It's a 2006 Campana T-Rex. Awesome machine. So I told you guys I was going to get to this time where I was telling you about it, a little bit about what's in the car, what's been done to it, performance mods and times and whatnot. So like I said, it's a 2006 Campana T-Rex. It's the special edition pearl orange. Very rare color. I got the wheels powder coated black to accent the rest of the car. The car has a carbon fiber package on it. It's only got 5,000 miles on it. Utilizes a Kawasaki ZX12 engine. And I've wanted one of these for so many years. Finally found one that was orange out of California. So I pulled the trigger and I bought it. It utilizes a lot of aluminum and fiberglass and carbon fiber. It's got like, if I can explain driving it, it's like a mix between driving an F1 car and a tricked out motorcycle. You're about 3 to 4 inches off the ground, and it's a fucking blast to drive. One of the fastest, best driving vehicles, enjoyment wise, I've ever driven in my life. And I've driven a lot of exotics and top end cars. This car takes the trophy by far. They are pretty pricey. They start out brand new at about $80,000. There are a lot of wannabe T-Rexes. The real deal is the real deal. So it's got adjustable pedals. It's got the removable quick release steering wheel. Come check it out. I'll show you a little bit about it. So these are Inky RPF1 wheels. They're an awesome, awesome wheel. I did the white or the orange ring around it. It's kind of fading a little bit right here, but who cares? These are a Bridgestone Potenza tire. It utilizes Wilwood brakes. Now this is the real deal car here, guys. This is no bullshit. You can see I bought my bracelet, my watch, my ring, and my shoes to match, just because how much I'm actually into this car. It's the enthusiasm I have for this thing is superior to none. It's in a league of its own. Has cross-drilled rotors. We'll move around to the side here. You can see the suspension. It's got coil, come over here, right here. You'll see it's got coilover suspension right here. Super thin lower control arm and super thin upper control arms. Your tie rods are very, you know, thin to precision. They're high quality. It's got a chin splitter, air splitter right here, air diffuser, whatever you want to call it. Like I said, all carbon fiber accents. Carbon fiber dash right here. I'm gonna try to make it quick so I can show you guys some of the video. The seat's really cool. You can detach and move, adjust these seats right here. Look right here. Inside this right here, I'll show you. This right here, guys, is the e-brake, okay? You release the e-brake right there. It's a sequential gear shifter, so it's just like a motorcycle. It's one down, five up. Neutral's at the center, and reverse is simply right here. You lift this up, and that's reverse. All of this dash utilizes a motorcycle dash, which is a donor bike of a ZX12, or the Kawasaki 1200. It's got your, you know, neutral, reverse sort of stuff right here, your time. This is also carbon fiber right here, your passenger side. A lot of people put stereos in there. I put my stereo under the dash, so it's nice and clean. I got my bullet style speakers right here. The airbox is a Campana designed airbox with carbon fiber accents on it. You get your ram air tubes right here that go ram into the bike. This is aftermarket windscreen. You got your GV saddlebags. They're an Italian saddlebag. That's right, represent Italian. I'm half Italian and half Irish, part Mi'kmaq Indian. I'm a slut. I mean, a mutt, whatever you call it. So anyways, let's go check out the back. I keep my shit clean, and this is kind of dirty today. So this is a D&D full exhaust system. This is also carbon fiber. The back right here, and this is a Continental tire. I was gonna go with my favorite tire, the Toyo Proxy R888s. I was waiting until this was gone. This is an Extreme Continental, so it's still good. Here's the gas tank, right, or the gas hole right here. there's so much about this car that is amazing. I can't wrap my head around it. I'm going to be selling it here soon in the next couple of weeks, I think. So with that said, I'm probably going to get another one because I'm infatuated with this car. They did a hell of a job building it. It's a company that started in 91, I believe, had some financing issues, was rebought, and then manufactured them in Canada, and they did a hell of a job. They're very, very intricate in what they did. Here's another thing too, is the Ram Air right here. This cools the radiator, and it also cools the engine down. You don't get that. Another thing too, the center of gravity of this car is insane. Like, the handling is so extreme. Like, you could take a corner at, like, I think I've taken an on-ramp. We're talking 180 degree on-ramp. I've taken that at about 75, 80 miles an hour. I've driven Dodge Vipers. I've driven Ferraris. I've driven Lamborghinis. I've driven all that shit, okay? This rapes them compared to that. This car just sticks to the friggin' road. It's insane. So with that said, let's show you guys the video and see how you like it. Peace out. Stop. Hey guys, what's up? I'm gonna give you a little demo on how this thing handles. I'm not gonna do anything crazy, but I'm just gonna show you its agility. Here we go. Downfall of the Campana T-Rex is this right here. When you go to get out of it, the cockpit's extremely small, and they do that for a reason. Is because whatever car that you're driving, your objective is to be one with the car. I know when I'm driving this, it feels like I'm incorporated into this. It's an amazing feeling, and I'll tell you one thing, it's well worth every penny spent on this because the handling is superior. And like I said, it's very confined in this cockpit. The bad part about getting out is this. You gotta kind of put your foot right here, do a split, grab onto this, and lift your ass out of the car without scratching the fenders. And that's really all there is about the car that I don't like, is just how it's kind of confined like that, but it's a thing that I do like at the same time. You can't be short to drive it, as I was telling my wife. She tried to drive it, and her foot were about that far from the pedals. But other than that, I'm absolutely in love with the car. So, hope you guys enjoyed this video, and there's more to come. Over and out.